story seems to have had a lot more traveling around before you.
Yeah, I've generally moved around a lot. Like my father was in central government service, so you know we were posted in Indore. That's in the heartland, you know, of Madhya Pradesh.
Right.
And then I've lived as you know as a young boy in Mauritius.
Right.
So I've done lots of schooling there.
Okay.
And then I went to boarding in Rajasthan in Mayo College, Ajmer.
Yeah.
So that was a place which played a lot of, you know, my growing up and my personality building.
Did you enjoy staying in boarding?
Initially, I felt homesick like any child would. Like I joined in 8th standard, which is not very young for boarding. Because there were people who were there from the 4th, 5th and 6th as well.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, the initial homesickness apart,
yeah.
I think I believe a lot in boarding education.
Okay.
Yeah, I tried my best to see if my son could also go, but anyway. But in those days, boarding schools were also of a good quality and good standard of education.
Right.
And overall, you know, sort of personality development was there and, you know. Kids becoming men, a lot of independence and you fend for yourself a lot more and all that. So like boarding and then of course got into college and was in Kharagpur. So I've like moved around a lot.
So that was IIT?
The IIT Kharagpur is where I did my architecture. And
okay.
So because I was away from home for a lot many years, so my parents were keen that I come and work, stay with them and work. So they were in Kuwait at that time. So
right. So
I think I 1989 I finished.
Okay.
So I went and worked in Kuwait in a big architect's office there. It's a very large firm, which one of the big threes of Kuwait.
Okay.
So,
and even before that, actually in school as well, you started studying more, which started leading you towards architecture.
Yes, you can say that in a way, because when I was in Mauritius, funnily enough, as young as like, you know, 7th or 8th standard, we used to have this course called technical drawing.
Yeah.
And so we got exposed, I got exposed to the idea of a T-square and set square way back in 7th, 8th in that range.
Yeah.
And you know, that curiosity turned into an interest.
Yeah.
And I kind of liked it.
Okay.
So I have, you know, I've been used to a small drawing board and a T-square, set square and, you know, making orthographic projections, plans and all that of simple objects. They were not of buildings, of objects.
Okay.
So that happened, it was a, you know, a small eye-opener for me.
Right.
And I kind of liked it. But then coming to the boarding school and then in my 11th and 12th, I did take engineering drawing as my fifth subject. It was
and
offered.
In Mauritius and in the 11th and 12th, was it an Indian syllabus that you were learning?
Yeah, no, Mauritius was not an Indian syllabus. It was not an Indian syllabus. It was, I learned French, I studied French there and all.
Okay.
I did French literature. So that was a 3 years of very different life.
Okay.
I'm saying that in 11th and 12th, while I was in Mayo in Ajmer, I had again a similar subject called engineering drawing that was offered at that time by CBSE schools.
Really?
As a fifth subject, like you take bio or you take economics.
Yeah, yeah.
So I took science with engineering drawing, ED.
Okay.
So that one particular subject, we'd break off into another classroom and back to T-squares, set-squares and like, you know, very nice. And we were taught by a very elderly gentleman who was a civil engineer and who knew his rudiments of drawing, drafting, and that's where my real fundas of, you know, plans, sections and elevations, again of objects, not so much about buildings.
Yeah,
it was sort of ingrained into me.
Right.
So when I joined architecture school in my first semester, the concept of, you know, plans and sections, they came to me much more easier, I mean easily, than to say someone who was not exposed to it.
Correct. Yeah.
So that's
started
how it started off and